actors to this deal, which we will...
He did his recruitments.
Which we will find out. Today, of course, we are thankful to have with us MLB Network, MLB.com, and Padres.com as well for joining us for our introduction of our newest member of the San Diego Padres, Xander Bogaerts, who is a two-time world champion, but even better person, which we are so glad to have him here today. Alongside him as well, the president of baseball operations and general manager, A.J. Preller, Padres chairman, Peter Seidler, and Xander's agent, of course, Scott Boras. We will begin with opening remarks from Peter and A.J. before we open it up to all of you for questions. So at this time, Peter Seidler, you're up.
Well, we've talked a little bit, but this is my great opportunity to formally welcome Xander to the Padres organization. I've heard from so many people in the past several days about your character. As a fan of yours and as a fan of baseball and somebody that's watched you perform at the highest level in the biggest moments, welcome to San Diego. This is a city that's headed towards its first world championship ever. We're doing everything we can to push that towards a reality. And then one of these years, hopefully soon, the baseball gods, I believe, are going to smile on this beautiful city. So welcome. And with that, I'm going to hand it over to AJ.
I think when we first started, the process was in right around Thanksgiving. I called Scott. And talked about his free agent players. I don't think he was quite expecting us to talk about Xander out of the group based on maybe the roster construction that we had, et cetera. But I think as we got into that first conversation and talked about, you know, our team being a team, you know, that we feel good about, and a team right on the cusp of a championship last year, you know, looking for that right fit, that right piece to get us over the top. And you know, talking about, you know, the type of hitters, the type of players and that you need if you're going to win championships, true, you know, 2-3 hole type hitters, versatile two-way type position players. And I think especially the makeup component that we focused on, knowing our players and the group that we have in the clubhouse, which is a, you know, a talented, tough group that is looking to take another step, and how that fit with Xander and his experiences. You know, I think we do a lot of homework overall, and this was a process really, you know, over the last year, kind of waiting for Xander's free agency from our pro scouting group. We had two players, Alan Craig and Ian Kinsler, that work in our front office now that played with Xander. When you get those firsthand experiences and firsthand accounts of, you know, what he brings to the table, both as a player and a person, that went a long way for myself, for Josh, and our evaluation process. We set up a meeting to talk to Xander about a week later or so in Newport, and it was pretty clear, like, everything that we had seen and heard from Scott, from our players, from our homework, and definitely had seen with our own eyes across the field, that came across loud and clear, honestly, a couple minutes into the conversation. I think Xander himself, I think one of the he turned himself, he said that he's baseball struck, and you know, we got to see somebody that loves the game, has tremendous, you know, tremendous intelligence and aptitude for the game of baseball. Somebody that's a great competitor, and, you know, is coming from a world championship organization himself, and has two rings. And I think all of those factors for us made a big difference, and were a big reason why we made that initial call, and then a big reason why we pursued him in free agency. I think the final step, you know, Peter kind of thought we were getting close to the finish line with Xander, and called on Peter to do his best Trevor Hoffman impression and close it down. And ultimately, we're really, really excited to have Xander here as part of the San Diego Padres.
Okay, at this time, we're going to do the photo op portion of our program with hat and uniform.
Close the button, or? Looks good. Thank you. My hair is not purposely this color, but it worked out great.
Yeah, there you go.
four great looking men, you got to have one or two good ones.
And now a few words from the man himself, Xander Bogaerts.
Hi, guys. Just want to start off by saying thank you, obviously, to Mr. Peter, AJ, for showing the strong interest, and obviously they were very straightforward from the beginning. I want to thank the Lord also to start off with, just guiding me to this path. Obviously, it was different, you know, and it was one that was very exciting, very fun, nervous. I did it all through that process. My family back at home. It happened so quick that, they couldn't come on a flight because it's a little too far from Aruba for them to reach in time. So I really thank them for their support throughout all the years and obviously in this process. Scotty B over here, thank you. Mike Fiore, I see you there. Thank you guys for Boris Korb just always being there and getting it done, you know, as you guys always do. Looking forward to playing here for the rest of my career. I saw Don as soon as I came in, and it was, haven't seen him in a while, so that was definitely happy to see him. It's been a while. Always a fan of him, just doing the games on TV and stuff like that. And also, I see Pete over there. I mean, I've seen him throughout my career. So I'm looking forward to this, man. I'm really excited. And San Diego was my first All-Star game back in 2016. So definitely, I envision myself possibly maybe being here, you know, one day. But after they got Tatis, so I was a little unsure. I was like, that doesn't fit, you know. So, but here I am, you know. It's crazy how the world works, and everything happens for a reason. So I'm excited to be here.
This time we have microphones on both sides of the room, and if you just raise your hand, we'll get them to you. First up is Kevin Acey.
Xander, what was it that kind of closed the deal for you and why you're here? And also, if you could put in your words what baseball struck is.
Baseball struck, man, 24/7 baseball. I grew up like that, watching baseball games, scoring baseball games like some of you guys might do growing up, watching a lot of baseball on TV. TBS had the Atlanta Braves. Andrew Jones was playing at that time, so I was locked into that every night. WGN had the Cubs. So, I mean, I know pretty much every guy on that team. And Sunday Night Baseball was mostly Red Sox, Yankees back then. You know, now it's different. Now you have Dodgers, Padres, or Cubs and Cardinals. So it varies. But, I mean, I'm just huge into baseball 24/7. After I play baseball games, I go back home and continue watching baseball. I mean, not necessarily of myself, but just watching my other peers, guys that I've played with or against that, I mean, I'm a fan of. So. Just 24/7 on it.
So what do you know about the Padres and some of the guys that you know here?
I mean, the roster is, I mean, I think it speaks for itself. You know, it's pretty stacked. Top to bottom, the pitching. I watched a lot of games in the playoffs, obviously, with that trade that they got Hader at the deadline. I know he struggled a little bit in the beginning of the season, but he finished the season extremely strong. So I saw another guy, Suarez. I didn't even know of that guy. But obviously, he's one of the best relievers in the game. He showed that in the playoff also. So, I mean, from top to bottom, roster-wise, I mean, it was unbelievable, the amount of talent that they have here and seeing the fan base, how amped up they were, especially like when you guys beat the Dodgers in the playoffs. I mean, it was something pretty fun to watch on TV, and I'm looking forward for that experience for sure.
AJ Casavell.
Xander, I know you spent a lot of time in the AL East. You probably don't have much experience with San Diego. I know you had the All-Star game. But how did you kind of go about learning what this organization was about and deciding that this was here, was the right fit for you?
I mean, in the end, the pitcher has to throw the ball, and you have to swing at strikes as a hitter. You know, I mean, just going into a new division, it might be a little different in the beginning, just trying to get used to the pitchers and the stadiums and stuff like that, you know. But, I mean, I'm a guy that adapts pretty quick and if it's not quick, it takes a little bit, but I'll try to adapt anyhow, you know. So, I mean, I know San Diego's on the west side. It's a little far, but, I mean, it's definitely a nice place. And as I said, it was my first All-Star game. So, I had a little bit special ties to that at that time and throughout these years. I played here, I think it was in 19 or 18. We had the player weekends, the white unis against the black unis. So I don't think I played too well. I might have hit a couple doubles, but yeah, no homers yet. But hopefully I have a lot of those.
I'm sure you watched as the Padres brought in Machado and then at the deadline this year, Soto and Hader, and they traded for some pitchers a couple years ago. What did you see from afar then before you even thought about signing here? What did you see from this organization as they started kind of building toward where they are now?
Obviously, I knew about their minor league system. I mean, this is prior to them trading for Soto. It was pretty stacked. They had a couple young arms coming up that were pretty good. A couple outfielders also that were pretty good. I mean, the major league roster in itself was already solid. But then you go out and you acquire a Soto from a positional player standpoint. I mean, he's really one of the exceptional players in the game. One of the really best players in the game. Has tremendous eyes at the plate. I wish I had some of those, you know, but maybe I'll borrow some of those from him. But it's definitely great, man, just seeing all the guys. I've been watching them play for a while, and as I said, I just watched that whole playoff run from Bell hitting that homer opposite field in the Mets. So it's pretty great to be able to watch them and now be a part of it. You know, I mean, it's crazy how it all worked out, but I was definitely a fan of these guys.
Troy Hirsch.
Hi, Xander, back here. Troy Hirsch with Fox 5 Sports. A couple questions for you, and one for AJ, and one for Peter, if I may. First, Xander, what position do you play?
I play infield. I play shortstop.
So there seems to be three or four shortstops on this team. Is shortstop your position, and is that what AJ has said that you'll be playing?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
It's just a topic around town is how is the Padres going to fit in another shortstop? And that's what I'm getting at is how does all these pieces in your mind fit together when you said yourself you didn't envision yourself being here with Fernando Tatis being here? How do you fit in, do you see?
I think I'll fit in great. I know it's a tough question, but, yeah, I think I'll fit in great. The more position players you have of high caliber, high talent, I mean, the more problems it creates, it's just the better, you know. Just us as players, just putting our egos, checking our egos at the door and just competing for one goal, you know, just trying to get a championship, all of us pulling on the same strings, pulling for the same goal. So I think in the end, it'll work out really well. As I said, we have a lot of talented guys on this team. I've played with a lot of talented guys in the past, so it should be fun.
You've won two World Series. Is there a characteristic on those two teams that you see is generally on a team that's championship, and if so, what is that characteristic?
I mean, 2013 was very different. You know, 2013 we played pretty much as the underdog. I mean, if you go and match up roster-wise, us against even like a Detroit Tigers at that time, where their roster were pretty superior to ours. You know, but our chemistry that we had that year, the beard thing we had going on that year, I didn't have no beard. I just had a little something here at that time. I was 20, 21 at that time, so I'm much older now. But this team definitely reminds me a lot of the team that we won in 18, a team that just was so superior to the rest, you know, just from roster-wise. I mean, it was incredible. It's just like every day we went into the ballpark, and it was like, how much was the score going to end? Although we knew it was going to be a W, it was just that good. That good our team was in 2018 when we won.
Xander, thank you. AJ, did you have a conversation with some of the players, maybe Fernando, maybe Jake, maybe Ha-Sung, about how Xander is going to fit in? And can you share with us a little bit about how that conversation went, if so?
Yeah, I've had a chance, and Bob's spoken to the players as well. I mean, I talked to Manny, you know, first, and just talked to him about Xander, and I think his quote was the more the merrier. And obviously, they've you know each other well from the American League East, so. He was super positive. And then, you know, the conversations with Jake and with, I think from Jake's standpoint, very similar, you know, talking to him about, you know, being able to play in different spots, everything like that. And we'll use the next couple of weeks and months to look more closely at that. And with Fernando, I think, again, like with Fernando, I think he understands he has the ability to play a lot of different areas. And I think the common theme for everybody was, you know, we want to win. You can feel that from you know all the players on the roster. I think my conversations, hearing Bob about his conversations, you know those guys reaching out to Xander in the last few days as well. they're just really excited and looking forward to winning. And you know, you need to do that with really good players. And, you know, we feel good about what we've got from a roster standpoint for sure and how it's going to fit together.
And then, Mr. Seidler, AJ yesterday at the winter meetings earlier said, use the term budget, but it seems like the Padres budget just continues to grow and grow, and I think Padres fans love that. Do you feel like there's a window now of opportunity to strike that you're in that you needed to make moves like this?
So a couple things. I've never looked at windows. We expect to be good year after year. And as an owner that will be in this game as long as I'm allowed to, we look at a very long-term perspective. We start from that. And signing a baseball-struck person with his level of commitment and leadership, those deals tend to work out. So strategically, Xander's a great fit for us. And, you know, in baseball, really like with all sports franchises, you can never be done because things always change. And, you know, I'm financially trained. I have a budget mind up there somewhere. And I think budgets get better when you win world championships, and that's our goal.
Peter Abraham.
Xander, you're in the Red Sox organization for almost 14 years. How difficult was it to kind of make that final decision to come here?
I mean, I was very, very thankful, very appreciative for my time over there. I ran along a lot of great coaches, great players. Obviously, in this game, you play the game to win, but also you play to create friendships and relationships. Still to this day, I have a lot of teammates that are I consider friends, you know. As I said, very thankful from managing standpoint, players-wise, teammates, front office standpoint. I mean, it was a great run, you know, but this is definitely a different challenge, one that I'm very excited for, looking forward to. Because as I said, this team really wants to win, and you can see how close it is, especially watching the games last year and these last couple of years that they went to the playoffs, like 2020 during the COVID year. But I mean, this year, seeing the fans and how electric it was something obviously we didn't have this year.
Dennis Lynn.
Xander, what's it like knowing that you might spend the rest of your career here, going from that 14 years in one organization and now, you know, 11-year deal? You'll be 40-41 when that ends. What is that? Have you been able to wrap your head around that yet?
Yeah, I feel great. I feel great, you know. I mean, sometimes it's a little hard to turn the page, you know, but, I mean, that's something that I have to do. And I said, like I said just now, I was very thankful and appreciative for my time that I was with the other team, with the Red Sox, and met a lot of people that helped me out throughout the way, helped me become the player that I am today, from coaches in the minor leagues to players that I have up in the big leagues that are also coaches. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to that challenge, man. I'm a guy that likes challenges, and this is definitely one that I'm looking forward to.
Obviously, your agent, Scott, he knows the market as well as anyone, but if someone had told you, though, at the beginning of the offseason that you're going to be able to get an 11-year deal, even with the way the market's going, would you have been surprised?
I would have kissed him. Yeah, I would have. I haven't yet, but I might do it after.
Was that your priority? Was that your priority going into the offseason to find somewhere to spend the rest of your career?
No, my priority was just going to a team that was very competitive, a team that wanted to win. And as I said, obviously, the owner didn't mention he doesn't like windows, but, I mean, this is not a window. This is something that's built for the long run, especially with the guys that they have on the roster, and the commitment to the guys that they have on this roster is for the long run, and I'm definitely looking forward to it, bringing a banner here and being part of that.
Allison Edmonds.
Thank you. Allison Edmonds, KUSI. Peter, a question for you. You know, with paying for four of the top superstars in baseball, does someone eventually in the next 10 years get left off, or do you expect to have these four players still looking for moving forward?
I think, like all of us, I'm day-to-day and year-to-year. But I think we have very skilled people, starting with AJ and his staff, that look through the roster construction and things like that from a long-term perspective. He gives me great advice, and I rely on his judgment.
Kevin Acey.
Scott, you were here or in Peoria 5 years ago when Eric signed, and you talked about the hot lava, where you thought this organization was going. It's turned out differently than that, but what are your thoughts on what the Padres have done or are doing?
You know, we're very prepared about what we've gone through, and we look into free agency. When AJ called me, I had this list. I remember looking at it, and I'm going like, well, who are the fits and what it is? And we have AJ's entire psychological profile on players down. And so we look at it, we go, well, these are the players that AJ really is going to look for. And he started talking about Xander. And then one thing we commonly talk about is that Xander has extraordinary bat-to-ball skills. And the one thing about on-base percentage, it's really an art form of his. And his durability, being able to withstand and play almost every game, every season, and having championship caliber. And all of a sudden, AJ starts describing how Xander fits in this lineup. So when I got off the phone, I went to our staff and I said, we have to do a better job of understanding how AJ thinks about how he puts teams together, because the logic of it became very clear about moving runners, advancing runners, getting on base, and also having a championship character. One of the hardest thing I think for players is that when you have unknowns and you have a process that is not familiar, you kind of wonder. You as good as you are and as brilliant as these men are, when you have not achieved that, you wonder. And to have someone who's gone through it twice and done it in a major market and endured the pressure and had disappointments along the way, is that so many players get to come and ask, is this the norm? Is this to be expected? And they have a championship library to really go to. And I think the greatest, it's just so hard to be through it once, but having gone through it twice and where Xander's at his career, I think it's a remarkable fit to add that experience to this kind of talent, top to bottom.
Peter, should more teams operate this way, the way that you are, where you're blowing up what are normal conventions?
As many of you know, my wife and I have three kids under the age of 10, and there's a couple teams I care about. This one right here and the youth sports that my kids are playing, I'll comment on any of those.
Yeah.
Xander, you mentioned the All-Star game playing here at Petco Park. This ballpark, your style, the way you hit, do you think your game fits with hitting in this ballpark where some batters come in and struggle more than others?
I think it'll do great. I do, especially playing at Fenway. Fenway has that big wall in left field. It tends to help a lot of guys that have more of a uplift in their swing. Well, I'm more of a type of line drive type hitter, so I'm definitely sure that I'll get more homers here than it would take away from me, because just the way my swing plays from the left field side here.
AJ, you brought in a couple guys now in the last few months, and Juan and Xander that have World Series experience. I'm guessing that's not a coincidence. Why is that so important to you, and what kind of factors from that do you think that you see these guys bringing here?
Yeah, I mean, I think we talk about it all the time, and I think, you know, Scott just mentioned, you know, when you have guys that have been through, you know, been through long seasons and then know how to navigate through a playoff season, been in big moments, they're battle-tested, and, you know, I think you look up, and again, when you look at the top players in the game, most of them are in winning situations, and they've won, you know, championships or been part of my own playoff teams, and there's no coincidence for that. You know, I think from our standpoint, we have now a group that's been to the playoffs a couple times in the last few seasons. But adding in Juan and Xander, you know, two guys that, you know, are both elite players, but they've also, you know, they've navigated through those, you know, those playoff, you know, situations, which our group had a lot of experience last year. We just thought it was it's a really good fit from our standpoint.
Adam Kluge.
Xander, since signing here, have you had a chance to connect with any of your new teammates? And if so, how have those conversations gone?
Yeah, I have. I have talked to a couple of them. It's been going well so far. Obviously, had to talk to Grish also about the number. That went nice. It seems like he's a nice guy. You know, I mean, he didn't have to do that because he has his time in the big leagues also. But it was very, very kind of him. I'm sure I have to take care of him, but that'll be taken care of. But yeah, it's been good so far. I've been talking to some of the guys. Won't get into who, but it's been nice so far.
This time we're gonna open up for any Spanish questions.
Gracias, Sander. Preguntarte rápidamente, ¿cómo crees que encajes en el vestidor, en el clubhouse, con mucho pelotero talentoso, mucho latino también? Y ahorita lo contestabas también en inglés, te pregunto en español. Petco Park, un parque donde sabemos que también te hubiera gustado después del All-Star Game batear mucho, ahora te va a tocar. ¿Cómo crees que encaje tu estilo de bateo aquí?
Sí, obviamente en el play de Fenway, tú sabes que tiene el monstruo verde ahí. Y está un poco más difícil para el swing que yo tengo. Yo no le doy la bola muy alto. Y entonces con el swing que yo tengo, que son un poco más alineado, para mí que va a funcionar muy bien aquí, un play muy espacioso. Obviamente yo soy uno de los peloteros que corren bien en Grandes Ligas. No soy elite en eso, pero gracias a Dios tengo buena pierna y a lo mejor las cosas salen bien, un par de dobles. Tengo un rato sin dar un triple, entonces a lo mejor voy a dar un par aquí también.
Sobre el clubhouse con otros compañeros, ¿cómo crees que te vas a sentir con ellos?
Yo creo que vas a estar muy bien. Yo sé que hay muchos peloteros aquí que son talentosos. En mi carrera he encontrado peloteros más talentosos que yo. Un par de peloteros en el equipo de Boston. Un par de estrellas en el negocio de pelota. Y para mí la experiencia ha sido súper. Y yo no veo que vas a hacer ninguna dificultad en eso aquí también.
Una para AJ, si se permite. ¿Qué fue lo que hacía tan atractivo a Xander para traerlo a San Diego y si se considera que es la pieza que falta para obtener ese añorado anillo de World Series?
Y, you know, pensamos que fue un buen fit, un buen conexión, porque Xander tiene, you know, tiene experiencia jugando en la Serie Mundial, en diferentes playoffs, y también como un pelotero y para batear en la medio parte de order. Y mucho contacto, y pienso que él va a estar un pelotero que puede batear en octubre, cuando el pitching, cuando los lanzadores son el mejor de lo mejor. So, por estas razones, pensamos que él va a estar bien con nosotros.
What you may not know is that Xander speaks 5 languages, so I don't want to leave anybody's language out. If there's anybody else who would like to ask a question, this time we'll open up to anybody else at this point. I think we're good. Thank you for joining us today. And again, welcome, Xander Bogaerts.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. I appreciate the time. Thank you.